Hey guys, welcome back to a quick video, well, quick by my standards, in regards to how I chart up on a sink or swim. I've had a few questions about it in the past. Some people think that I'm using a special software that I superimpose onto my sink or swim charts. That's not the case, and I'm just going to show you guys quickly how I do that. Now, the charts I'm referring to are those ones that I usually I used to post them on Twitter, but then now I'm just using them in my recap videos. These ones are relatively nice and neat. I just like to mark up where I entered a stock and a little bit of an explanation as to why I entered, and I'll mark some exits either with more bubbles and lines or just some arrows if I want to just summarize a series of exits. These ones look relatively straightforward. I got my trend lines in, entries, exits, explanations. Nice and neat. It can sometimes start to look a little bit busy, like this. I like to use different colors if I've entered the trade more than one time, just to separate the two trades. I would consider that. Sometimes it can get really epically, like, lots of colors, and we tend to refer to this fondly in the chat room as my seizure inducing charts, which was coined by Jonathan S, one of the Trick Trades members. Because I like to use, well, these aren't fluoro, but bright colors, because I like to be able to differentiate between all of my explanations. I like to talk a lot, and I also like to talk a lot within my charts as well. So just going to quickly show you guys how I chart this up. So in the think or swim chart, I like to trade and chart off the 1 minute time frame. So I will just zoom into the point of the chart I want to focus on. I usually like to drag it out and up, make it look a bit centered if I can. I do have some OCD tendencies. I will change the volume bars again because I like my charts to look a certain way. So if I was to want to use a bubble to circle the candle that I entered in on, then you can access the drawing tools here. Right now it's set on a price level, so if I wanted to mark possibly, you know, a level of resistance or support on the day, I would just choose that price level, which is that dollar sign with a line underneath it, hover over to the area I want to mark, double click, and it appears there. If I want to edit that line, I would just right click over it, edit properties, and I can adjust that to be the whole number if I wish. And I can change the color here. I can change it to that, or I can choose a whole range of colors from their grid here. Might want to choose that color. And you go, okay. So that's a price level. Now if I wanted to use a price bubble, I would click there again, and this is what the, well, I call it a bubble, but it's an oval. And let's just say I enter the position on this candle. I would click here, and you don't have to hold the button down, and then just do my second click there. It's not a click and drag. I used to try to click and drag, but when you click and drag in think or swim, it just highlights the area of the chart you want to zoom in on. So it's not a click and drag, just click and then click again. Now if you want to edit that oval, you just right click it, activate drawing, and you can make it bigger, smaller, really really thin, or whatnot. Let's say I want to highlight all of these bubbles, and then I can drag it, as long as it's still activated, as long as it's highlighted in this bluish kind of color, I can still drag it and adjust it as I want it to be. Same thing with this. Any drawings that you place on the chart, you just have to right click it, activate it, and once it's highlighted, you can drag it wherever you want on the chart. And again, if you want to change the price level, you just right click on it. So that's that bubble, sorry, oval. Now, you can also access the drawing tools up here too, but there's more clicks involved in this one. You have to go here and then to drawing tools and then select. Whereas down here, it's just the drawing tools are one click away. Trend lines, I like to use just this one. Now, this one is also a click and click again, not a click and drag. Just two clicks to signify the start and end point. Again, you can edit the color and so forth. You can make it thicker if you wish. You can make it super thick if you want. And if you decided that no, I like it this thin, I like it this style, I like it this color, you can save that color as a default so that whenever you draw a trend line, that purple line comes out as opposed to the blue one I had before that I have to change the color for. So that's your call. Now, when I want to write a text note, pretty obvious, just go to text note, click wherever you want, and then it will open up a dialog box and you can type in whatever you want. And same thing, once you've typed it out, you can right click, edit properties, you can change the color, the font style, the size. I want a really, really rock, bold, italic. So these are the most common tools that I use when I'm charting up. When you guys see my charts on my videos or on Twitter, mostly trend line, price level, text box, oval, and arrow. Sometimes I do use an arrow. So say I just wanted to point to a particular area here, I just click once. That's my default color and direction of my arrow. Sorry, but I can right click, edit properties. Say after this point I want it to be a blue arrow. I always want it to be pointing down at any given moment. I want it to be an extra small one. I can save it as a default, or you can just click OK and it will just change that one candle. Go OK. And it becomes teeny tiny. I don't like it that small. I have trouble seeing to begin with already anyway. Now, at any one point, if you just want to quickly make another arrow, but you don't want to go through all that process, then just right click on that. Duplicate drawing. Once it's highlighted that blue, darker blue color, click it somewhere else. And again, duplicate. Same goes with this. I want to duplicate that price level and drag it there. I want to make another bubble, right click, duplicate. Same thing with this text box. You can drag it somewhere else and then you can edit that once you get there. That's it. Same thing with the trend line. So yeah, that's how I chart up, guys. And then once I've charted up, I just use my snipping tool that comes with with my Windows 10 anyway. And yeah, that's how I post it on social media and in my videos. Hope this helps you guys. For those that are wondering if it was a special program, it's not. It's preset in thinkorswim. Even in the app version of thinkorswim on my mobile as well as on my tablet, you also have these awesome drawing tools as well. You have access to all the same ones. It works a little bit different when you don't have a mouse though. You just have to use your finger as the first click, second click, and so forth. But yeah, I really love the drawing tools on the thinkorswim platform across all of the devices. I use them across all of the devices as well. So yeah, hope that helps you guys, and I will talk to you in the next video. See ya.